Hello, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'll be showing you how to make paper butterflies, and all the materials will be listed below the video. And the template has two versions of the butterfly also linked below the video. I cut all the pieces I need on white cardstock paper, and I usually prefer text weight around 65 pound cardstock. I use this travel watercolor brush and paint the center pieces in orange, and you could get creative with this and try different colors, but this will be the orange monarch butterfly look. I have the page setup file for you as well, and you can see on there that you will need two sets of the left and right wing black pattern and two sets of the orange centerpieces and only a total of two pieces of the white. For the second butterfly, I wanted to color it a little more pink, and you could try that look too. Next, color the black part with black marker. I'm using the Sharpie, but if you have a regular black marker, it should work too. You could also use black cardstock paper for this part, but I just like having everything cut in one sheet of paper if I can, and the black marker isn't too much work to color. Leave it to the side to dry while you work on the next part. We'll be working on the body of the butterfly. You'll need a small strip of foil, and I like to measure it out with the width of the white wing piece from the template, a little over an inch or so. Then roll up the foil like a shape of the body. I also like to taper the ends by making it look like an oval. Next, you'll need 5 black floral wire. I have that linked below the video. You could also use green floral wire if you have that, and paint it black if you don't have black wire. Grab 2 wire and twist with the length enough to be the antennas on the head. I always go a little longer and then trim it down later, so you give yourself enough room when you are cutting these wire pieces. The antennas will be on one end of the foil body we made, and the other end of the wire I wrap around the middle, top of the bottom, wrapping it once or twice, and use the other ends of the wire as one set of their legs. Then take the next wire and wrap that around the same area as the previous wire. That'll be the second set of the legs, and then wrap another wire around the same area for the third set of the legs. The foil body should have 2 antennas on one end and have a total of 6 legs in the middle. At that last wire in the middle, and that'll be attaching the wings, so let that wire go towards the top side of the body and have the legs on the bottom side of the body. Next, take some masking tape and cover as much of the foil as you can. I tore some of the masking tape down the middle to make it thinner to go between the wires as best as I can. Next, you'll need a small oval piece of black felt. This is optional, but this black felt will be for later. It will go on top of the body to add some texture to the body. Leave the felt to the side for later. Next, cut a few pieces of black tissue paper and use matte Mod Podge to cover the body, and add black tissue paper to cover the body. It should take about 15 to 30 minutes for it to dry, and once it is dry, you could hot glue the black felt oval onto the top toward the antenna. Think of it like a little jacket for the butterfly. Next, get all the wing pattern ready. We are starting with the orange set, and you should try to piece together all the pieces and have it ready before we actually start gluing, just so you know all the pieces are matching. First, add a little Mod Podge to the orange piece and match the black pattern. Next, get the white piece and glue that behind the orange. You should see the white part peeking out on the top and side holes of the black pattern. Then get the bottom wing pattern and match that to the bottom area of the wing. This piece should overlap on top of the pattern above. Do the same thing to the right wing. Add the black pattern onto the orange shape and then add that to the right side of the white shape. And I don't think I recorded a video of this part where I also glued it to the white shape again for some reason, but make sure to add that to the white shape also. You should have the left wing and the right wing ready. Then with the extra pieces, make sure to go in this order. Glue the black top piece on the orange and only the top piece. Then get the wings, and before you glue it all together to the body, measure the wire and make sure it is cut before the wing. Then put the right wing and add the glue on the white side with the black wire on the wing. Then get the matching side of the back side of the right wing. Then finish up the wing with the bottom black pattern. Then get the other side wing and glue the white area again and the wire. Then match up the rest of the pieces. This should take about 15 to 30 minutes for it to dry, and while you are waiting, you could cut the wire pieces to the length you like and just even out the lengths of the legs. I also wanted to show you the pink version, and instead of using Mod Podge, I tried it with this white glue. I added the fine tip to the glue, which helped get the little details on the pattern. I think overall using this white glue was easier and less messy, but the final look, I actually like the Mod Podge look, even though it is the matte Mod Podge. It gave it this sealed look that looked more realistic and less like paper. So you could try either way and see for yourself. This pink pattern is slightly different because I wanted to make two different versions available for the template. This one is meant for a more open-winged butterfly, and the orange version was meant for a butterfly with its wings up. So you could switch it up with their shape and color to have a variety of different looks. You could also adjust how the wings are up since the wire is inside the wing. Also, once the glue is a little dry, you could also shape the wings just by curling the tips, very subtle, but just making sure it's not completely flat. You can go on to the next chapter if you want to look at the final look. I think they are going to pair so well with some paper flowers, and I think you could try making this in giant size, which would be so much fun to make. Please like this video below and subscribe. Thank you for watching.